Everyone, welcome to round one. We have lost the roll and we're staring back at a hand that's a little slow. We do have one of our two drops, which is okay-ish, but we have all of our manas necessary to cast spells, so we're gonna go ahead and keep this. Would you like to mulligan? No. Our opponent has chosen to play first and has kept his seven. And we may want to play the Eidolon out. We'll just have to wait and see. We're playing against black, so there are a few cures to play around. We don't have any double white or double black, so it doesn't really matter which land we play first. And it seems like we may be playing against some return phalanxes. So immediately out of the gates, you can see there's an Omen Speaker. And I'm less likely to want to play the Eidolon because of that, even though it means we could take a bunch of damage from this little Chip-Hits, but I'm fine with that. Or maybe not. We've got the Ordeal, so definitely more of a reason to play this. So we're going to go ahead and cast this and hopefully not get too blown out. Cards went bottom top. And if our opponent chooses to play a creature with less than two power, we should have a good line with attacking for one, or attacking for two rather, and then this guy should get out of hand. We can set up a Divine Verdict next turn potentially, but it really depends on what our opponent does this turn. And we're getting in there, so we're gonna go ahead and not bother blocking. And this plays into Voyage's End, but you know, what are you gonna do? So we'll go ahead and leave up God's Willing mana and get to town with this guy. Hopefully it works out. Please don't tap any mana. And there we go. We even get to play around with the possibility of getting a counter before he Voyage's End it. He's just letting us get that much enjoyment out of it. It's creating quite a bit of suspense. And actually, he has the Voyage's End, which sucks, I guess. That's all right. So next turn, we'll go ahead and play a Raptor. That card went to the top with the Scry. And then now he goes for Swamp and is continuing to bash. So he knows we don't have God's Willing in our hand, obviously, because he successfully resolved that Voyage's End. And we've got a Disciple of Phoenix, which is going to take a look at two planes. These 1/3s are pretty good against our Anvil Rot Raptor. So we're going to go ahead and reveal those. You get your choice. You can't even choose between two pictures, so... Oh, right in time. So we're going to go ahead and play this, and hopefully we don't get too blown up by the Farika's Cure. This guy is not exactly resistant against interaction, especially against a bunch of 1/3s. And he's tapping his mana pretty quickly, so he's got something that he really wants to play. Another Disciple. Alright, well, he's going to get a look at our entire hand. Probably taking a spell, I would say, if I had to guess. And after a little bit of time, he decides to get rid of the Eidolon. No surprise there. So we're currently a little behind here. And Lash of the Whip. Well, that's something. I guess we can just attack and... I don't really want to use a Divine Verdict on either any of these creatures, but we're not exactly in a good position here in terms of the board. But I can only assume that we'll end up drawing a creature that we'll be able to change that. And a Gray Merchant. So, let's see. That would be draining for 6. What we can do is we can Lash of the Whip it in response to the trigger. It is the biggest creature, and so that seems like a reasonable line. And this Divine Verdict is still going to be good. But this is going to make it so that we end up saving a bit of life. This guy's got quite a reasonable black devotion deck, it seems like. Hopefully he doesn't have too many more of those cards, and hopefully we draw a creature, because I really want to stabilize the board. And a Raptor. Well, that's certainly something. He knows our hand, so he knows we have God's Willing, but he doesn't really have much action in his hand, considering he only has one card. So We're gonna go ahead and hold back for one turn at least, and then if we draw another creature, we can start bashing for four, and we should be in a good position after that. And that's a return phalanx, so that's not gonna do anything. And so we'll go ahead and draw this sentry, so that's pretty reasonable. What we can do is play this first and then attack. If he has a removal spell, I don't really want to double block with either of these, especially considering we have the God's Willing, and I'm okay with taking a little bit of damage this turn. Going down to 6 from the return phalanx, and then afterwards we can just Divine Verdict it. It seems like this attack is, I mean, this is the turn that we're going to be the most vulnerable, but it seems like holding back these guys is, it can go either way. This is definitely a more aggressive line for sure. And whether or not it's a little too risky is definitely up for debate. And it seems like we have a little bit of a trick. Bestowing Baleful Eidolon onto his disciple. So he's going to go ahead and go in for 5, and that's fine. Attacking with everything? Well, that's pretty mediocre, I think. We're going to go ahead and block this guy. Taking 6, going to 3. And now we can change things up a little bit. We can Divine Verdict this. Block God's Willing that. Going to 2. And yeah, that's going to be better. So we're just going to attack with everything in pass. And then if he wants to attack like that next turn, we should be okay. So hopefully he bricks here, and we end up being able to attack and then play this guy out. We can hold one of these guys back, or two of these guys, depending on how much damage you want to go, or do, and depending on if he attacks with this. It looks like that's what he's going to do. He's getting ready to turn on his return phalanx. And he's going to try and take us down to presumably 2 life. So we're going to go ahead and block here. Then Divine Verdict this, and then give our guy Pro White. And if we were to get Stymied Hopes, we would want our Divine Verdict to resolve. So we're going to cast that first. Granted, he knows exactly what we have in our hand. So this, he knows that this is a possible line, assuming he thought about it. And now we're going to go ahead and give our guy Pro Black. And we can put that on the top if we really want to. Given that we're going to 2, if he were to have an Intimidate Aura for this, then that would be good. Also, this gains 3 life, so I think I'm going to go ahead and put this on the top, just because it saves us from Gray Merchant. If he draws it next turn. Oh no! Oh, a Keepsake Gorgon. Well, that's certainly scary. All right. So what I think we can do is just attack with everything, and then pass the turn. He'll have the option of using the Monstrous on to kill our guy, our sentry. And at that point, he'll have 5 power on the battlefield. But we can use the Ray to gain some life, and then kill him with our next with our flyers on our turn. So I think that seems like a reasonable line to take. The other option would be to just play the Griffin, but that's not going to be as enticing, because it'll give him a little, it's not going to be as as good, because we're giving him effectively the win. And I would assume with no cards in hand, drawing to one, he's not going to have a better option. And it looks like he's going for it. So we're just going to go ahead and destroy that in F6. And we'll go to sideboarding. Look at that. Not going to bother regenerating because we don't want to pay any life. Going down to one, then taking him down to zero. So, not going to show him any more cards. Hitting him for a lot of damage, and there we go. Let's go to sideboarding. So there are a few cards that we can definitely board in. We have the Dark Betrayal, which is going to be pretty good against his Keepsake Gorgon. And he's pretty black-based, so I can definitely see this being pretty reasonable. Excuse me. Looking at the rest of his deck, we saw one Aura. So that might be good enough to keep this in. And he does have Voyage's End and is playing blue, which makes me less inclined to play the Boon. The Battle Priest is fairly unimpressive. He did not appear to be very aggro, so I can definitely see boarding out the Ordeal and the Battle Priest for two Read the Bones, especially since he's got a bunch of discard, having cards that end up drawing. Basically, having a lot of drawing power is pretty good when we're playing against a bunch of Spectres, and we have a bunch of removal ourselves. So I think I can make that switch without too much worry. And we might, since we took out one, actually now we have to put a Read the Bones out. So if we want to put in another Read the Bones, we'd have to take out something. And it's actually unclear what the worst card is going to be. The Warden seemed like it's pretty reasonable. He does have a lot of small creatures. So I think I'm going to go ahead and just try this.